Welcome to NASA's Kennedy Space Center. We're here on top of the Mobile Launcher Tower, more than 400 feet off the ground. The beach is right there, it's super windy. You can hear construction noise because this is a construction zone. I'm Joshua Santora, and today I'm gonna give you a behind the scenes look at some of the work being done to prepare for the Artemis program. At the heart of that program are the Space Launch System, SLS, our heavy lift rocket, the Orion crew capsule, and Exploration Ground Systems. They're responsible for all the infrastructure to actually launch. Today's tour will take a closer look at infrastructure like this tower and the pad that it's sitting on. Be sure to enjoy the view and look around wherever we go. All right, let's hit it.
You're now looking at the world's largest single-story building, and through the open high bay doors, you can see the mobile launcher we were just standing on. I don't want you to take for granted the size of this building. The Statue of Liberty on her pedestal are shorter than that tower. And we don't call it mobile for nothing. We're going to fast forward a bit to after that mobile launcher has been carried out to the launch pad. Here we go. After the 11 million pound mobile launcher completes the journey out here to the pad, which takes about 8 hours, this is the view from the deck, where the Space Launch System, or SLS, will be stacked. If the rocket were here, you'd be looking straight ahead at the main engines. The hole below those for the exhaust is just in front of you, and towering overhead is the actual tower that will provide fuel, power, communication, and crew access from the ground to the vehicle through what we call umbilicals. Remember, you don't just need to provide necessary assets to one rocket. Each stage is essentially its own rocket. You have to provide fuel to each stage. Each stage needs power. Each stage has sensor data that has to be shared. And then you have to account for the fact that a 322-foot-tall rocket is going to sway a little. You need an arm to help hold it in place but still allow it to shift some. That movement is all understood and expected based on the detailed engineering analysis done by the NASA team. Once the rocket rolls out here, there should only be about a week of work before we're ready to launch. When we get to launch day, there's a ton of work being done both here and in the Launch Control Center to actually fly this thing into space. Let's head up and have a closer look at the tower. If you're afraid of heights, don't look down. The umbilicals I mentioned a minute ago are actually giant steel structures, like the one we're hanging off the side of now, the crew access arm. Another major umbilical is for the interim cryogenic propulsion stage that you can see below us on the tower. It's like a two-story tall steel structure that has to disconnect all of its connection points safely without breaking them so they can be reused, and then swing that 70,000 pound arm more than 90 degrees to be clear of the rocket, and do it all in under 4 seconds. That is some impressive engineering. In addition to the beautiful landscape, you probably noticed those two giant towers. Those are two of the three towers that make up the lightning protection system for the launch pad area. They're each 600 feet tall. One of the most important reasons we're talking about this rocket at all is the ability to transport humans deeper into space than ever before. Let's get a closer look at where our astronauts will be boarding the Orion spacecraft. When NASA astronauts enter this white room to climb aboard Orion, they do so knowing that there are thousands and thousands of men and women who have worked for years to prepare, build, test, and have confidence in the world's most powerful rocket. On launch day, that yellow cargo net and covering behind it won't be there, and instead, they'll be looking down into the crew capsule. As the astronauts take their last steps on Earth, right here before blasting off into space, they know they're taking another giant leap for all mankind. And this giant leap brings us all one step closer to pioneering other worlds.
We hope you'll continue to track our progress as we work towards the first woman and next man to walk on the moon. From KSC and for Exploration Ground Systems, that's all for today. Remember, we build, launch, and recover for the next evolution in humanity's deep space exploration. We'll see you next time.